Do you use charts?
Yes.
Do you copy-paste those charts in PowerPoint?
Yes.
Now, do you know how to animate charts in PowerPoint? Probably not. So that's what we are going to see today. Why would you want to animate charts in the first place? So let's understand the concept first. We create the charts in Excel. We put data, we put charts, then we copy-paste it in PowerPoint, right? When you copy-paste in PowerPoint, it's a link. I hope you know that. What does that mean? When you change the data in Excel, it's going to change in PowerPoint as well, which is a good thing. Now, one common mistake people do is they want to customize the chart. They customize it in Excel and then put it in PowerPoint. You can do that, but actually, you can customize the look and feel of the chart in PowerPoint. That is better. Do you know why? Because when you're looking at the chart in Excel, how many people are looking at it? One, that is you. You're trying to understand what is there in the chart, interpret it, thinking, what is the conclusion? All that you're doing on your own, correct? Now, when you're presenting that chart, you've already finished that interpretation. You put the same chart in PowerPoint. Now, do you want your audience to do that thinking all over again? That's a waste of time. You already know what to tell them. So whatever is the conclusion should be more obvious for them. That's why you should customize the chart in PowerPoint to make that conclusion easier to grasp. The data still changes in Excel and it will reflect. So far, so good. But where is the animation part? So let's take some example. Then you'll understand. So let's look at this chart. It shows me monthly data, monthly revenue for entire year. I show the chart as it is. I have put data labels. I have beautified the chart. Everything is great. What is the question people are going to ask? What happened in May? Because the revenue for May looks very sad. You have to put this in PowerPoint, present it to people, and then remember, oh, people are going to ask that question. No, you already know people are going to ask. So rather than putting the chart as it is and waiting for them to ask the question, why not prepare yourself? And that preparation can be as simple as animation. Concept is simple. You know the revenue was poor in May, and I'm assuming there is a reason why it is low. You just need an opportunity to tell that story as to what happened in Jan, Feb, March, April, which led to low revenue in May. Now, if that is the case, I will put animation. Now, which animation to put? You already know that. There are many types of animation. Have you seen all of them? Entry, emphasis, exit, and motion path. Which one do we need? We want entry animation because how the chart comes on and people see the chart. Okay. How many entry animations you know? No, not the ones which are seen on top. If you go to more, then there are 40 of them. Have you seen all 40? No, then just do a favor to yourself. Open that dialog, say auto preview on, just click on those 40. So now because this is a column chart, of those 40, you have to choose the best one, which will explain it correctly. So in this case, x-axis is starting, your y-axis plotted. What is here? Zero. Everything starts from zero upwards. So, wipe from bottom is the correct way to do this. Okay, very good. So, we applied wipe from bottom animation. Now, you run the chart and it is not what you wanted. Why? Because it applied the animation to the entire chart. What is the point? Earlier, people were seeing it in one stroke. Even now, they are seeing it in one stroke. Nothing we have improved. So, wait. Don't give up. When you apply animation, these 40 things are called animation effects. And for each effect, there are effect options. Maybe you have not noticed them before. So go there. Now, of course, it's wipe. So right, left, down. Okay. Below that, look at it. Now, it understands it's not just a wipe effect. It is being applied to a chart. Oh, chart has x-axis. That's called category. And y-axis. That is called series. So do you want it to apply by category? Yes, but not all categories. All categories in our case means Jan to December, all months. Say, no, I want to apply it by element in category. Ah, now try. Open the animation pane and see what happened. There are 12 months. So how many clicks you have to do now? 12, right? No, wrong, 13. Why 13? Because that grid of the chart itself gets one click of its own. If you want to remove that, go to settings and say, don't animate it. Now we have 12 clicks. That may sound like too much of trouble, but look at it from storytelling point of view. Now you are in control. You click, only Jan is shown. Now you talk about what happened in Jan. When you finish, go to click Feb, then talk about, you decide how much time you want to spend on each month. And finally, when it comes to May, you know it is going to be low. Others don't. So you quickly go, show May, show June, May, quickly. And now you have managed the show much better. So that's how effective storytelling can be done by correct chart animation. So before you animate a chart, of course, you need to customize it. But you should not customize similar data chart again and again. For that, you should use chart templates. I have a short created for just that purpose. Have a look. The link is above. So depending on the situation, you can use category or series and individual element or the full category or series. Here are some examples. So depending on the type of chart, you choose the correct animation. Earlier, we had a column chart, so we say wipe from bottom, right? If it was a bar chart, wipe from left would be nice. If it is a pie chart, then wheel is the correct animation to use. Depending on the chart type, you figure out what makes sense, what makes logical sense, and then you use it. I'm sure you found this useful. You know what to do. Share it, try it out, subscribe, click on the bell icon. And most importantly, if you have a question or an idea, put it in comments. I'll be happy to help you. And before you go, I have a very popular video about the top 10 PowerPoint settings you must change right now. Have a look at that, and then we'll see you next time. That's it. Bye-bye.